people have been making baked potatoes the wrong way this entire time. Potatoes are the most versatile vegetables around. From these humble spuds, we can make french fries, hash browns, wedges, and countless other delicious dishes. But of all the possible variations, the best might just be the baked potato. So, what would you say if I told you that you've been baking them wrong all this time? Instead of wrapping them in foil, throwing them in the oven, and calling it a day, there's a new way to bake potatoes that's not just the best way, it's the tastiest way too. Are you ready for the secret? Hold tight. It's a fact that potatoes are one of the most multi-purpose vegetables in existence. There are so many different dishes you can make from them, but it's important to prepare each one the correct way. For instance, there's a good chance you've been making baked potatoes wrong your entire life. Making them professionally, though, is a breeze, that is, if you know the trick. To make them the most delicious way possible, start by slicing a side off the potato. For the next step, use a small knife to cut rings around the inner portion of the potato, as demonstrated. Now, cut the sides of the potato all the way around, but leave a small uncut circle on the side you didn't slice. Use your thumb to measure this part. Below, you can see the exact place where you should make these small incisions. You'll want to be careful to do it in that exact spot. Now, when you flip the potato back over to the starting position, you should have something similar to this. If the cuts need to be just a little bit deeper, do so. It's crucial that you do this correctly before you move on to the next step. For the final step in the preparation of your potato, brush the vegetable with olive oil and sprinkle a dash of salt on top. This simple seasoning will ensure that your baked potato has as much flavor as possible. Now you're ready to start baking your potato. Place the spud in a foil-lined tray and move into the oven at 425 degrees for 30 minutes. Afterwards, when you take it out, brush on more olive oil and place it back in the oven. The fun part is coming soon enough. While your potato is likely fully cooked after these initial 30 minutes, a second baking is going to give it the crunchy texture that usually only restaurants are able to achieve. This is what your potato should look like after those extra 30 minutes. While this is all it takes to make the potato in its most basic form, there are ways to make an already delicious dish even better. For some added awesomeness, throw some cheese on top and bake for an additional 5 minutes. Cheese is the perfect way to dress a baked potato after all. But there's something even better than just a delicious crunchy baked potato. A loaded baked potato, of course. So it's time to make some more additions. Now's your chance to take those bacon bits you've got in your cupboard. You can even fry up a fresh pan yourself. Once you finish that, feel free to sprinkle on the bacon, because who doesn't love bacon, right? Any other fixings like sour cream are welcome. This is your baked potato after all, and you can put whatever you want on it. Just be sure to share the recipe with your friends, because they're going to be asking for it when you have them over for dinner. Now that is a baked potato. If anyone needs us, we'll be in the kitchen making one. Bon appetit. Share this secret to making the perfect potato with your friends below.